Let us say that you want to build a landing page like this. Few images scroll in the background. The background images exactly fit within the browser window and we don't see any scroll bars. You know that carousel component in Bootstrap can be used to implement this feature. So you head up to the Bootstrap documentation, you copy the carousel component sample code. In the carousel component sample code, I have already included the image links in the SRC attribute of the IMG tag. Now I am opening the browser to see how this page looks like. In the browser, we can see the images scrolling one after the other. The scroll bar is appearing in each page as the image is not fitting within the window. Let us look at this page in the mobile view. The image is occupying a smaller portion on the top. As this is a banner image of the landing page, it would be good if the image occupies the entire height of the page. Let me show you the ideal way on how it should be displayed. This is from the example that I have already completed. Here the image is enlarged and occupying the entire height. Each image is not fully shown, but it is showing the central portion of the image. If you want to know how to make the carousel images occupy the entire height and to make it responsive, then this video is for you. Continue watching this video to see how to get this implemented. The main change that we are going to make here is to remove the IMG tag and place the image as background of the enclosing div tag. This will give us more control to handle the image behavior using CSS style properties. First, I am commenting all the IMG tags. Then I am including a custom carousel image class for all the carousel item div tags. This class will help us define common background styles that is required for all the carousel images. Since each div is going to have different image, we will have a separate class defined for each div. For the first div tag, we will add it as bg-img-1. For the second as bg-img-2. And for the third one as bg-img-3. I am saving the changes. This HTML page is already linked to styles.css. I am opening styles.css. For each carousel image div, the respective bg-img class is already included here with the background image property having the respective image URL. Let me go to the browser to see how it works. We will not see any image as the div tag is not occupying any content or space. Let me go back to Visual Studio Code. In styles.css, I have already included the carousel image class definition. The styles included here will get applied to all the carousel image div tags. Here I am going to include height property with value as 100 VH. VH represents the viewport height. This represents the height of the browser window in whatever device this page is going to be viewed from. The 100 here represents the percentage of the device height that needs to be occupied. I am saving the file and checking it in the browser. Now we can see the image displayed with each image occupying the entire height and width of the browser. But we can also see that the images are displayed in its original size. The third image has a lesser resolution, hence it is getting repeated. Let us check the image in the mobile view. We can see the image occupying the entire height now, but similar to desktop view, the images are displayed in its original size. Let us now go back to VS Code to make few changes. In the carousel image, I am adding a new property background-repeat with value as no repeat. This will avoid the image repetition. Let us check it out in the page. We can see that the repetition is now gone. Let us go back to Visual Studio Code to make the image occupy the full screen. I am including the property background size with value as cover. This will make the image to scale and occupy the entire height and width. I am saving and checking it in the browser. We can see all the images properly fitting within the height and width of the browser. Now let us check how the page is seen in the mobile view. In the mobile view, the image is scaled and showing the top left corner of the image. Hence, it is not showing the main content. Let us include one more property to get this fixed. I am including a new property called background-position with value as center. This makes the central part of the image visible in the browser. Let me save and check the result in the browser. Now we can see the central part of the image shown even though it is not aligned correctly. This is a much better view than what we had earlier. Let us check out in the desktop view to be sure that it works in all devices. Let me summarize all the changes done. In the HTML, the img tags are commented. Then we included two class definitions in the carousel item div. The first one is the carousel image for specifying common styles for all the carousel images. Then we included unique class names for defining the background image. In styles, we defined the background image URL for each carousel image. Then we included height as 100% of viewport height. Then we included the property to avoid the image repetition. Then we included the property to make the image scale according to the size of the div. Then the property to show the central part of the image instead of the top left corner. Hope this video helps you on understanding how the background properties in CSS help to control the behavior of the image to be displayed. The sample code demonstrated in this video is available in GitHub. The respective GitHub repository link is available in the description of this video.